Hey everyone, I thought I'd just provide a quick walkthrough on what I've done in order to keep my motorcycle battery topped up and maintained while I'm either going camping or just in storage throughout the winter. Now you can actually buy kits with a PWM solar charger, but I'm using a MPPT just because it's a lot more efficient, especially with a smaller solar panel. I'll show you what I did and how to do it. I need a solar panel, a MPPT controller or a PWM, some wiring, preferably an SAE connector to an Anderson plug, which could be different, it's up to you, a way to connect to your solar panel as well, and I'll show you what I've done. So here I've got just a Anderson plug with the SAE connector, which I made, adding some terminal ends so I can connect the wiring to the MPPT. I did have to crimp a little bit in order to fit those pins through. Just tighten them down, and then I made another wire as well. Now in order to make a connection, I am going to flood solder these wires with an Anderson plug. Now to do that, you just crimp them down a bit more than what you'd normally would, and fold them over themselves just because it's very thin gauge wire. So flood solder essentially is, so you heat up the lugs, fill it up with solder and just dip in the wire to let it cool and harden. It will make a solid connection without needing the needle crimp. It's totally up to you whether you want to crimp it or flood solder. I just go flood solder just because I can make it removable just by heating it up and take out the wire. Now because it's such thin gauge wire, you will be a struggle to put it into the Anderson plug, so just put it in there with a screwdriver. Now here I'm just testing to see if the Anderson plugs work, which they do. So I'm adding glue just to help prevent moisture from coming in, and as well giving a bit more life to those lugs and wiring. Generally people who pull on Anderson plugs, they pull on the cable to disconnect them. This way you have a bit more security with the glue. Now here I am just cutting the ends off the wire that came with the solar panel. Now this solar panel isn't going to be the one that I'm going to carry around camping. This is just one that I have laying around that's off my off-roading trailer. Now here I'm just extending up the cord as well, just to give me a bit more breathing room, because when you camp 99% of the time, or with the bikes in storage, it's in shade. Now so with the longer cord, you put the solar panel in the sun and run a long cord to the charger to the. Now I actually forgot to add the heat shrink before I soldered these two wires together. I'm just going to tape them up. It's not really going to matter. There's not much current or heat passing through these wires regardless. Here I'm just adding some protection onto the wires just to give them a bit more longevity, and adding some tape onto each wire with a different color just so I know which is what goes to the battery and what goes to the solar panel. They are a pain to put on, but you'd rather have some protection than none. So here I'll just putting them all next to each other to see if I've got everything right. So here on the bike you can see that there is an SAE connector already connected to the battery. That is actually from a trickle charger, but you can get those connectors just off eBay. Now what I forgot to mention is you will need a fuse between the MPPT and your battery. Important that you'd have some kind of safety between the solar and your battery. So from here you connect the Anderson plug with the SAE, and from the Anderson plug you connect it to the MPPT solar charger. From there you just plug in the solar panel to the MPPT. Ready to go, but unfortunately on this day there wasn't much sunlight. So here we are on the next day, just to seeing on the process on how it's all charging, and you can see here that the solar light is green and the battery is fully charged now. Perfect for anyone that's trying to keep the battery topped up, maintained while it's in storage for winter, or you simply go camping and you know you drain a lot of the battery while you're out, whether it's to charge your phones or heat up some water or whatever it might be. So that's my quick video on how I've connected solar to my bike's battery. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. Check out the forums. I'm pretty active on there. Sometimes I do take a while to respond though. And remember, stay safe out there. Dress for the slide and not the ride.